Okay, Josh, do you want to see something cool?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to light this candle, and what should happen is the wick burns.
And you up.
And what happens now?
It'll melt. See, it melts.
Oh, yeah, you're right. So once it's got a little wax around, I'm going to blow it out.
Yeah.
And I want you to watch very, very carefully. After three. One, two, three.
You don't touch it!
That's right, you don't touch it. Candles are made of wax. When you light the wick, the heat melts the wax and turns it into a liquid. This liquid is drawn up through the wick. As it travels up the wick, the liquid gets hotter and evaporates. It turns into a gas. The gas mixes with the oxygen in the air and catches fire from the original flame. Once this happens, the candle flame comes from the burning wax gas, not the burning wick. When you blow out the candle, the wick stays hot for a while, so the wax continues to evaporate. This means there's still some gas above the wick. So when you bring a flame close to the wick, this gas catches fire and relights the candle. Okay, Josh, now I've got a jar here. I'm going to put it over the top of the candle. What do you think will happen?
It will go out.
It will go out. Why do you think it will go out?
Because the air doesn't come in.
The air doesn't come in. I wonder how long it will take for it to go out.
Immediately.
Immediately. Okay, well, let's have a go. A candle flame is the result of a chemical reaction between the gas from the wax and the oxygen in the air. When you trap a candle under a jar, it only has a limited amount of oxygen. When that runs out, the candle can't burn anymore, so the flame goes out. Do you think it changes if I change the size of the jar?
Yeah.
Let's have a go.
That takes a longer time.
That's interesting.
And it goes out slower.
Should we have a go with a bigger jar?
Yeah.
Do you think we can time it?
Yeah.
Science experiments often involve changing one thing and seeing what happens. We can learn about the world just by looking at things, but scientists usually go beyond just looking and measure things. Measurements help describe things more precisely and make scientific results more useful. To find out more about this activity, check out the worksheet. And remember, you can subscribe to more great experiments. And don't forget to send us your photos and your videos.
That is so cool.